I'm the CFAM bus driver. We're in Shipshewana, Indiana. 8 o'clock concert tonight. We left home about 4:30 this morning. And here we are in beautiful downtown Shipshewana.
How many times has the Collingsworth family been here?
I don't have enough fingers, I don't think. I really don't know, but they've been here a bunch.
And who do we have out here with us?
We have got Emma, and we've got Winston, and cousin Reed Archer Brinkman is along this time.
Hey everybody, we just finished a concert here in Shipshewana, Indiana, and we're gonna give you a little life update tonight. Phil and I started 2020, January the 1st, we had two grandbabies, Emma and Winston, most of you know who they are. And then our son Philip and his wife Charlenae, they had a little baby boy, Noah Timothy Collingsworth, on January the 31st, and he is a precious baby. And then, as you can see right here, we have a COVID baby coming. This little girl, she's my little girl. She's not little too right now, but she has 11 weeks to go. Sorry, Brooklyn. Yes. Till she delivers her third baby, which would make our fourth grandchild. And tell us what his name is. It's a boy.
Wellington Henry. A lot of you have seen that on social media already. It's not a family name. Well, Henry is. Henry is like a great uncle, grandpa's uncle.
Okay.
Grandpa Keith's brother. Anyways, but yeah, Wellington, we just liked.
So we were so excited about that. And then we got some really, really special news again this year. So God has been giving us all kinds of new little blessings. Courtney,
yes.
Tell us about
it. In April, we were matched with a little boy from Thailand. And me and Michael are Mom, what's the right English there?
Michael and I.
Hey, she taught me English. If I don't know it, it's your fault. Michael and I are adopting a little baby boy. And his name is Theodore Michael Tawin Metz. And we're gonna call him Theo, and he should be coming in the next 3 to 5 months. We have to go pick him up in Thailand, and he is just the cutest thing you've ever seen. He's about 16 months old, just about. So.
And I already have his picture framed in my house, and I walk past it and look at him and think, he's already part of the family. We've never even met him yet. He is a beautiful baby boy. That tell us about not being able to show his picture yet.
Yeah, so we can't show his picture to you guys until his adoption is finalized in the U.S., and that is about a year after he comes home. So you guys will not see him for a little while unless you come to a concert, and then you can see his little face. But yeah, we won't be able to show his photo for a while, but we will show you as soon as we're allowed.
And COVID, to be honest, has really presented us some new opportunities because we get to go to church at our own home church a lot more than normal, which has really been a blessing. Brooklyn got to lead the music for the Vacation Bible School because, of course, that allowed Emma and Winston to be able to go. Olivia did some team leader, and it was just amazing how everybody was able to get involved in just activities and events that we typically would miss because we're on the road. So Olivia, oh my goodness, Olivia has a lot of friends, but during COVID, I just have never seen you bring so many new friends around from church. She's met all these people that we, you know, once a month we go in and, hey, how are you? Oh, the Collingsworth family's here. Hi. But that's about the extent of it. And so now that we're here and they can't get rid of us. So we're at church. And so she has met, really, maybe you already were acquainted, but has really gotten to know some of these young people. And so she's, tell us about that. I think last Friday night I came home to a whole...
Yeah, mom and dad were out of town last weekend, so I called her and I was like, hey, I'm having a bonfire at our house. I think we had 12 people and they were all there till 2 a.m.
Okay, whatever.
Olivia loves to be with people and I just love to be home. So.
Yeah, that's true.
By herself. Olivia is my kindred spirit because Olivia loves to be with people up to a certain limit.
Yes, that's true.
And then Olivia has to go to her room and close the door and say, okay,
goodbye.
I've got to be alone. And she gets that from yours truly. Now little Brooklyn over here, see, I can call them that because they're my girls. They're all married and grown up and I'm not their boss anymore, but they'll always be my little girls. So Brooklyn, she's a socialite till Jesus comes.
Yeah, that is the truth. I think I've always been that way.
Courtney is a hermit till Jesus comes.
Yes.
She kind of gets that from her mama.
Guilty.
But you like to be around people.
I enjoy it when I get there. It's just getting there. That's the hard part. It's getting her out of her house. She'll get me out of my house. I'll be like, why didn't I do this before? This is fine. It's so true. Every time I invite her out, she's like, I guess I'll come. And then when she comes, she's like, man, we should really do some other things. This is fun.
I was like, come out of your cave every now and then and you'll find something happy.
But this year has been crazy, and obviously adding all the babies and new family members. But yeah, I think we're going to need that new bus soon.
Yes.
It was supposed to come before COVID, and it got delayed. But this year, by Christmas tour, it looks like it'll be here, and we're going to need it because we're going to have like two or three more babies on Christmas tour. So.
Praise Jesus. It'll pretty much be me and the babies on one bus, I think. Yeah. We're going to be relegated to putting all the children on
Basically,
one bus.
Basically, William and Brooklyn and their five children, no, just kidding, three children, they're going to have their own bus with the nanny, of course.
Philip will be on the bus, and then Char will be traveling with us some more.
Yes.
So little Noah will get to come. So y'all are going to have... And then tell us who's going to be on the second bus, the new bus.
Who is gonna be?
Oh, me and Courtney, Michael, and Theo when he gets here, and then mom and dad.
Yes, Theo's gonna get spoiled being the only kid on us.
I know he is.
So we're trying something new because Brooklyn is our oldest daughter, and Brooklyn, I think she doesn't mind me saying this, she's a mama's girl. Is that the truth?
Yeah, that's true.
She likes to hang with me. I like to hang with her, and she's not going on my new bus because Courtney said, "Hey, mom, I've not had any kids. I get you now."
Right.
That's kind of true.
It's gonna be fun,
but the perks of that are there is only one bedroom in each bus, and I will be queen and bee on the other bus, so
you
I
get all the closet and the shoe space. No fair.
Exactly. So I can handle that. That's not a problem.
But even now, Phil and I have been getting a hotel room, getting off the bus because this little girl, she needs a big bed to sleep in right now.
Yes.
How do you feel about that statement?
How many times has mom said big?
Hey, we can make that statement because I've been there with her.
I'm not offended. You know what? It's something about a third baby, and all you moms know this. They just pop right out on you. There's nothing to hold them back because your body knows what to do. So
it's beautiful.
Actually, our nanny and social media manager, Emily, which you all know, has been calling me affectionately, and she keeps telling me it's affectionately. She calls me Big Mama, so
yeah,
I'm owning
it. I like it. Owning, girl.
Owning it.
So that's a little bit of an update for us.
Yes.
So
we hope to see you all soon. Come out and see us at our Christmas tour. And we also have a November full of dates. So come and see us before the end of the year.
We'll see you there.
Bye.
Winston, what did you see just walk by here? Okay, never mind.
All right. Now what else?
Did you like that?
Go.
Oh, Emily.